yeah, reaching my generation. Wow, over these 808, eating these instrumentals. Wow, like I won't save a plate. Feels like it's midnight in Miami. Vibing like it's midnight in Miami. Yeah, reaching my
ladies and motherfucking gentlemen. How are you doing today? It is a beautiful but gloomy Sunday morning or noon, for various reasons. Beautiful because we have joining our illustrious show the very own, the very talented, the very strong Rafa. How you doing, brother?
Come on,
as you always,
podcast man, for real. Thanks.
Yeah, brother, thank always. You for coming on by, brother. We appreciate that. As always, we got ill-logicz with us.
What it is, yo?
What's happening? And we said that it's a little bit gloomy because before we get into Rafa, before we start talking about life a little bit, we just got some breaking news. Ill, how about you break it to them?
So our very own Rafa informed me, and I thought it was fake, that Kobe Bryant died in a helicopter crash. And I couldn't believe it because that is, again, my favorite athlete of all time. He is a fucking living legend. And that is the guy I looked up to. And when I play ball and I do things, I do it like with him inspiring him my moves and everything because of how aggressive he was. So it was a lot. It was a lot now for me to take in. And then,
it was a lot.
You know, once TMZ reported it, we knew it was
real.
That's
when you know it's real, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
And Ill is a true professional for, you know, just charging on, you know, and being able to keep it together, you know.
Nah, but for real, though, like that man, bro, rest in peace. and my condolences to his family because I know they're going through a lot right now, so.
Yeah, that's crazy. I'm far bigger into soccer, so I guess the way that I can relate is if like Messi were to die or something like that. So that's fucking crazy.
Yeah, he was a huge legend. So
He's young. How old is
41, bro. 41.
That's young. And what was it? A helicopter crash?
Yeah, yeah. There's no details.
Yeah,
on it,
I was gonna ask you. Are there any details out?
I don't think so.
No, I think it's too early for that.
Yeah,
so. It's a little early. Yeah, it just happened. So we lost a legend, ladies and gentlemen. But in other news, we have joining us Rafa today. Rafa is a professional bodybuilder, and altogether, you're strong, man. I'm gonna tell you that, bro. I'm gonna tell you that for the people that are not on YouTube, boy, get on YouTube real quick.
Yeah, sure. That's gonna be the next step for me too. Joining YouTube. I should start doing that.
All right, hell yeah, bro. Hell yeah. Come on, give everybody a couple tips, you know.
I noticed that the bigger people get, the more they wear long sleeves. It's like they're trying to hide it.
Yeah.
Because they don't, they're responsible with their power. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They don't want to just show the world.
No, of course. Yeah, yeah. No, I'll break it out when I need to break it out.
Yeah, when I need to.
Yeah.
But not now. But when I need to.
Yeah. I'm going to leave the AK in the trunk real quick.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, yeah, for sure.
It's just a surprise.
Yeah.
is he fat? No.
Rafa, what's going on right now? What do you have going on? Or is there anything you're working on? I know we were talking about maintaining weight. That's something kind of that you're working on right now. Why don't you give our listeners a little bit of a backstory of you?
Okay, so when I started bodybuilding, I was into men's physique, una categoría. So now I'm kind of big for men's physique.
Yeah.
So now I need to go up another level, which is classic physique.
Okay.
So we are in the process to improve some body parts, like my legs that are a little bit behind, but just keep on working.
What are some of the different levels like you're talking about? You said classic physique?
There's men's physique, which they use the board shorts, so they don't focus on the legs. Everything is like upper body.
What? Oh, I didn't know that. I didn't know that was different.
See,
okay.
I didn't know that either.
Yeah, so then you have the classic physique, which is they're trying to look for that body type when Arnold... And that era.
Okay.
And there is bodybuilding, which is the monsters.
Yeah.
Big boys.
Hey. Yeah. So now I'm trying to move into, with my coach, we're trying to move into classic physique, which is more, a little bit more details and show the legs and some muscles.
The details, yeah. I heard you say your coach, you know, helping you.
And also, I've seen you myself, how you coach other people. What do you feel is some of the differences in when you're coaching someone else and when you have a coach?
Well, a coach needs a coach. I always say that. So if you want to keep learning, keep improving, and your knowledge gets a little bit bigger, you get more knowledge, you need a coach. So for me, is I treat everybody's different. So the way my coach coach me is not the same way I coach my clients. And the way I'm getting coached right now is to compete, like competition level. And most of my, like 99% of my clients are just for lifestyle.
Okay. Gotcha. What are some of, I saw your before and after picture, was which is fucking
that was crazy.
Do we have to go there?
We do.
Two different people. Yeah, completely.
For real. First of all, I thought it was two completely different people. That was number one. Number two, the people, they're seeing it on the screen right now, and I'm sure they're gonna be like, "Who the fuck is that?"
Yeah.
What was the point, the day that you're like, yo, fuck this shit? Like, what made you have such a drastic change? Because I think I don't know if the change can be overnight, or, you know, that you make up your mind as far as, hey, I'm going to have a drastic change. But even if it is, the actual action obviously is not overnight. You know, that takes a long time, and it takes a lot of determination, a lot of repetition. Yeah. So give me a little backstory on that. How that happened? Why that happened?
So basically, I always been into fitness, but not as deep as after I had an injury in my knee, ACL reconstruction. I went up to around 240, 100 pounds, which is the before picture. And I remember. Like it was yesterday. I went to Santo Domingo, to Dominican Republic.
Okay, come on, somebody. Hey, for all my Dominicans out there, come on, somebody.
Hey.
So I saw a picture on the beach, and I was like, nah, that's not
me. Nah. No.
So, and when I got back, I was like, no, I'm just going to jump into it. And I can keep being like that just for my own health.
You know? And for somebody who's working out myself, I think one of the hardest things for people to do is stay motivated.
Yes.
So what do you do that keeps you, like, while you're working out and you're tired and you're just like, man, I don't feel like doing this right now? Yeah, or like when you wake up, like, how do you do it? Like, what
helps you put the blinders on? You know?
Bro, yourself.
Okay.
In my case, myself.
Yeah.
I want to keep improving. Every day I want to be just better.
Yeah.
I want to keep getting stronger. So it's the motivation is in you. Just need to find it.
Dope.
It's there.
Dope. Dope. Self-motivate yourselves, people.
Self-motivation.
Come on, somebody.
That's very, what's up.
Very
that's
important.
What are some of the lessons that you try to impart on your students?
Well, in regards of?
Training. I mean, I know I know a lot through social media. Some of your students are some of the most consistent. I see them constantly in the gym, constantly going. And I don't see them having that kind of like fall off. Sometimes when you really get into something, sometimes there's a fall off point, and maybe you feel like you've reached that goal, or maybe you feel like you've lost a certain amount of weight, and the abs are coming in, they're not coming in, and you're like, fuck it, let me eat this pizza.
Yeah,
you
know? Fuck this.
So yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I think when you hire somebody like a coach, that person needs to motivate you too, you know. And that's why I think that's one of my other motivations that I have, besides myself, it's to motivate others. When everybody sees. So if you're pushing hard, you're getting your goals, like closer to your goals and stuff like that, your clients will like, man, if my coach is doing it, why can't I?
What do you think would make a bad coach? Or what do you think someone who... When you see someone that's private training and you're like, I don't know what the fuck is, you know, like,
not following through their clients, not giving them that motivation, not doing things right, especially when you're exercising, you have to keep those movements right, man.
Mm-hmm.
So any wrong movement just can fuck you up and you're out.
for a couple of weeks, and that takes that motivation off. Mm-hmm. That's for sure.
So the form, like, aside from just building the muscle, the form is also very important so that you could avoid injury.
Injury, and actually that you get better performance with the muscles. So you're going to get that advantage of using the muscle, right? Extension, contraction,
okay.
You know?
Okay, cool.
What's a normal day-to-day now compared to, which I'm sure is still some ridiculous regimen, compared to when you're in prep for a competition or something like that?
It's very strictly.
Yeah?
Like, yeah, the training doesn't change that much. Mm-hmm. We just add some cardio, increasing the cardio a little bit, like getting closer to the competition. But the training by itself doesn't change that much. Maybe the weight and reps a little bit, but the food is
where
the thing is. Yeah, the food is, man, if you there, you know, if you're ready to accomplish your goal or not. Mm-hmm. That's one thing that motivates people. Like, that's a challenge.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, if I can do that, if I can get to that day doing like sacrifices, all the sacrifices that you have to do, then you can accomplish anything.
Yeah.
That's what's up. Give me a little insight on your personal experience with competing. What was the last time you competed, or the first time you ever competed? What did you learn in between? What was your experience like?
Well, my first experience was in 2016.
Okay.
And I did it just as a challenge for myself too. Mm. And a few people that were telling me like, oh, you should compete. And I'm like, you know what? Now that I'm into training, coaching, let me just give it a try so I have the experience. It's like, if I don't like it, I just stop doing it. But man, I got hooked.
Hell yeah.
I got hooked. So I just like one competition, then the other one, then the next one.
Yeah.
And I've done now about five competitions.
Wow.
Jeez.
Five shows.
What's some advice you would tell someone that's considering trying to compete?
Be serious about it.
Yeah?
Yeah, because if you're not serious about it, you're going to be cheating here, cheating there. And if you're not strong enough, you're just going to end up quitting.
Yeah. So, speaking about cheating, a very hot topic in the world of bodybuilding and working out in general. But
I
more
you
so,
were going to talk about like a relationship or something.
Oh, no. Nah.
My girl.
My girl. Shout out to that. No. A hot topic in the world of bodybuilding and, professional bodybuilding competitions is the use of steroids or any sort of anything to try to give you a better edge or that sort of thing. What's your take on it? What's been your experience when you went to competition? Are they open about it? Talk to me about that a little bit.
Well, in the NPC, which is the National Physique
Competition?
NPC. Don't tell me I forgot that.
You got it, bro.
Hey, don't worry about it, because you know what? We got the sign on the screen right now. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So it's all good.
So that's there's some different events.
Okay.
Committee? Committee.
There you go.
And
that's a bilingual right there, baby. Committee. Come on.
Come on, somebody.
So there's some that are like steroid free. They test you right before you go into the show and everything. But there's others that don't. Mm. I'm not against it.
Okay.
Just like I'm against of the bad use.
Mm. You're against
or the abuse.
Okay. Yeah, the overdoing it.
Yeah. So if somebody have like a wrong idea about it and just like jumping into everything they heard, they listen in the gym and stuff like that, that's not good. That's not the right way to do it.
Well, there's another misconception about it. I think people think that you just pop a pill or do an injection, all of a sudden you have muscles, but that's not happening.
You still need to wake up 4 a.m., put your cardio in, get all your meals, get your tilapia.
Yeah, get that tilapia.
Get that tilapia and broccoli.
That fish.
So if you don't put the workout and the food together, steroids, they won't get you anywhere.
Mm. No, that's tough.
Talking about that, because I know, again, one of the more important things about, the whole building muscle is what you consume. And we were talking about earlier before the show started. And I don't know why we didn't wait for the show. But either way it goes, you was telling me you don't really drink protein shakes that often. So what do you eat, dude? Like, to continue to build and maintain what you have, what do you eat? Like, do you eat like 16 meals?
Yeah.
Every hour he eats a steak? Like, what the fuck?
Do they know your name at Costco?
Yeah. What the fuck, dude?
No, but I'd rather to do the meal. As I told you earlier, I'd rather to have my 6-7 ounces of chicken or lean ground beef. Yeah. Lean ground beef.
Lean ground beef.
Lean ground beef. Yeah, make
lean.
Sure.
With emphasis on the lean.
Yeah. A good amount of rice, you know.
Okay.
So, but there's where the coach comes in.
Yeah.
You know, they track your body, your improvements, your weight and everything. So that you don't have to kill yourself like, okay, what I'm going to do today. No, you know, somebody is like,
hell yeah. Did you ever need someone constantly like texting you like, hey, get your ass to the gym, you know, like do this? Or were you ever you were always on top of yourself?
I'm always on top of myself.
Yeah. That's what's up.
There's some days that, man, I'm telling you that everybody lose that motivation that day, one day, like I have to train. But as I'm a trainer, I'm always in the gym. So I'm, you know what? I'm right here. Let me just get it done.
Exactly. Yeah. You're going to have to be there regardless. That's a great way to look at it.
Yeah.
What do you feel are some misconceptions about bodybuilding that you'd like to maybe give our listeners a firsthand experience that maybe it's not like that, or maybe anything that maybe you've heard about the sport that bothered you before?
That's a tough question. Mm-hmm. I never like to talk about, like, in competition. There can be a lot of stuff, man. There's a lot of politics. A lot of stuff, but I'm not saying that. Okay, but there's a lot of stuff when it comes to compete. Who's your coach? Who, things like that.
Gotcha. Yeah. What would are men and women in the same competition?
Yes.
And
but just different, like, girls on the side and guys on the side.
Do they have pretty much the same, I guess, setup, same treatment? Is it pretty much the same competition?
Yeah, it's pretty much the same. So they have the different categories as well.
Why is it so much more difficult for women to build muscle than it is for men?
It's just their metabolism is like very different as ours, you know.
I didn't know that. I mean, I know it was harder for them
to lose weight as well. Build muscle is like,
really?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, ladies. You guys are amazing anyway.
We still love you.
Yeah, we still love you.
Most of them know that.
They know the struggle. They know the struggle.
Yeah, I have a lot of girls asking me that, like, why I struggle so much and my boy just like lost 5 pounds in a week, which is not healthy though.
Okay.
But yeah, man, girls takes longer.
Speaking about healthy and not healthy, Rafa, what are some gym myths, some rumors that maybe aren't true? I mean, I know obviously the staying hydrated is very true. You have to drink a lot of water.
Yeah, definitely.
But is it true that you shouldn't eat, eat past a certain amount of time? Like they said, don't have your last meal before 10 or something like that, because you store fat when you're sleeping because you're not working out or whatever.
Yeah.
What are some myths that aren't true?
Yeah, they say that don't eat those carbs like late night because you're going to go to rest. Mm. So it's the less, your body's working less. So the less calories you're burning than during the day. But everybody's different. Mm. Like, my man right here can eat like 8 ounces of pasta if he wants at night.
And I eat carbs and I eat chilling.
So for you and me, eating that at night, it will.
Yeah, that's brutal.
We made something against what we want.
That's fucking brutal. What
we suffer too though. I want to make something clear.
Wait, let me speak up for my people.
Yeah. Every time it's always the same. Oh, you lose fat. I mean, you lose weight so fast. And it's like gaining weight it's so difficult for me. And it's a lot of work. And it's like some people think, oh, because you lose weight fast, like you're happy. And it's like, no, man, like I'm trying to gain weight. It is just as hard for me to gain weight as it is for you to lose. So I mean, we're battling two different
things. I think it's even harder.
So it's a body type.
Oh, we got words from Craig. And ladies and gentlemen, that's the first ever mic'd up words from motherfucking Craig. Can we say that again? Can you say that one more again?
Body type.
Body. That's Craig. Yo, that's Craig's voice. That's for those who never heard him.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's That's the word.
So I have the pleasure to be the first one.
You have the honor. The honor. That's the first time. Episode 10. Right.
Episode
10. Got to do a double digits. You know what I'm saying?
Come on.
So yeah, body types. Talk to me about body types a little bit. Do you think that someone who is quote unquote big boned is always going to be doomed to like being a little chunky, or do you think that if they work at it,
they're good? I mean, that's a mesomorph. What they call a big boy.
Yeah.
So they can trim down, man.
Yeah.
I mean, they're gonna be like their hips are gonna be like different than an ectomorph, which is.
What are the different types of body types?
Yeah, right?
How many body types are there?
Like, there are three, but don't put me in the spot right now because I don't remember.
Don't worry. So it's
ectomorph. Endomorph and mesomorph.
See, you do know.
So what am I? Which one am I? What do I fall in?
Ectomorph.
So what? That's like you burn fat.
Your metabolism just go faster, and you can eat a little bit more than us.
Oh, no, I read anamorphs. I know that much. Anamorphs. You know what I'm saying? Turn into an eagle real quick.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Jesus.
Nah, man. Craig knows what I'm talking about, yo. What are some complaints that you get from some of your clients? Not about, obviously, your coaching style or anything like that, but about maybe, I mean, obviously, people are going to complain about not getting results quick enough. Or are most of your clients looking for a physical transformation, or are some of them looking for actual strength?
All of them are like physical transformation.
Yeah.
All of them. I haven't get a client like for a long time that is training for strength.
Gotcha.
But there's totally different trainings when you work towards strength and towards a physique transformation.
Mm.
So, but right now, all the girls that I'm training and all my clients, they just like want to transform, for tone up, get that small,
that peach booty,
the peach booty,
come on, that lab, legs, abs, and booty,
come on, somebody,
you know?
Yeah, that's one of my classes.
Yes, check it out. Fight Club. Are there any places?
Not yet, but
Fight Club.
I would let people know about it.
So sure, you coach both genders, right?
I only have one. I train one. Yeah, I train both.
Okay, so how frequently do your students, like the girls, hit on you? Is this like a common thing? Is like,
gotta ask.
You have to, and especially he's Dominican. Ask. So no. How many Dominican poppies do you get from the women? Like, hey, poppy, I mean, coach, like, you better chill.
No, that's it.
No? Okay.
Everybody keep it
professional. He's keeping it professional, guys.
Okay,
I'm going to ask him after when the cameras aren't rolling.
The cameras aren't rolling. Okay.
No, all my clients keep it very... Okay, they're okay, professionals. Okay. I mean, most of them, 99% of them are, on a relationship.
Okay.
Gotcha.
But how many of those are loyal? You know what I mean?
What do you...
100%.
That's a good number. That's a good number. 100%.
100%.
Out of all your clients, what are their motivations for working out? I mean, some, you know, like you said, they're trying to get that summer body or whatever the case, and they have physical goals. But are some of them, is there like a spark that causes the transformation? Like maybe there was a bad breakup, so they want to, you know, look better than, you know, whatever, or maybe they're training for a photo shoot. Like give me some numbers.
I think. Most of them, I think all of them, they just like fall off the wagon.
Fall off the wagon,
and they just want to get back to it. So most of them are like that. That's why they want that transformation, to get back to it, or maybe improve their legs. Because I'm very known for legs training.
Okay.
So that's why I have the class called Legs, Abs, and Booty, which is only mostly for girls. Now they're accepting some guys.
Okay.
Which I'm sometimes against.
Why?
No, it's just for respect for the ladies, you know.
Okay.
There's some exercise that the girl is gonna be like and better.
Yeah, in a weird position.
But up, and you know, the guy's gonna be in the behind, and you never know, you know.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, and you want them to feel comfortable at the end of the day.
Guys, yeah. Front row, no exceptions.
Yeah, you have to keep the guys in the front.
I'm gonna start doing that. Keeping the guys in the front. That's a good idea.
Hey, come on, they're gonna hate me, yo.
So, did you in your experience of coaching and training, did you ever see anything crazy as far as injuries go? Like somebody drop something or somebody break something?
Yeah,
or
I've
anything?
Seen some of those YouTube videos and they're fucking brutal,
disgusting,
bro.
Dude.
None of my clients.
No, okay, good.
None of my clients. No, I have zero. I started in 2015 and I have zero injuries under my
supervision. Well,
that's a great fucking track record. So. But not necessarily one of your clients, but maybe you were at the gym and someone else was, you know, near your vicinity.
Yeah, I've seen some. The craziest thing that I had was actually was one of my, considered my friend, and he's another coach.
Okay.
On the leg press, he fucked up his both knees.
So did he like bend back?
Actually, to the side.
Oh,
but he couldn't manage la creta.
La creta.
So he couldn't manage like get out of the leg press fast. So
okay, good.
So, it was really bad.
What was his recovery time like?
He's still recovering.
Fuck.
What? That was a couple of years ago.
Okay, I mean, so now that we're on this topic,
shout out to him. I hope you're getting a speedy recovery, brother.
Yeah. Because that's, I mean, just having to recover for something sucks. Because then it goes back to what you said. You lose your motivation, and it's like, damn, you know, you feel down. But I've also been now on the health side. I know you focus on working out, but I'm pretty sure that also comes with some type of knowledge on like health. Because I know for me, for instance, sometimes I'm doing my leg press and my knees start to hurt. Mm. Or I'll play basketball and I'm jumping a lot, my knees start to hurt. Yeah. What can that be from? I mean, I don't know if you would have any knowledge on that.
I mean, that could be, do you drink multivitamins, your minerals? And
I just started taking multivitamins.
Yeah. You see, things like that. Or you just have, before you get into the injury world, I think you should like relax the muscles around the joint.
Okay.
And stuff like that. Because sometimes the muscles get so tight and start pulling the ligaments, tendon, and everything.
Okay.
So if your knees start hurting, you actually, your quad can be so tight that it's pulling, and that's why you're feeling the pain.
Oh, shit.
And so for me, when somebody tell me like, oh, my knee hurts, okay, the first thing we're going to do, it's like let's relax your muscles around your calf, your quads, hamstrings, and let's see how you feel after that. If not, then
you gotta go ahead,
go and check that out.
Go check it out. Okay, because I never stretch.
Let me start off real quick.
I'm gonna be real with y'all. I'm not gonna be fake. I never stretch.
Never stretch.
I just go straight into working out or playing ball.
Yeah.
And
I only do excessive weight, weight that's way too much for me.
I just start with heavy weights when I'm squatting. Yeah. Two plates on each side. Let's just go with it. And so my knees start to hurt. Sometimes my lower back hurts. And I know it's a bad thing. I get it, but
he gets it.
I feel like I'm immortal. You know what I'm saying? I feel like God gave me, you know, and until the day, hopefully, God forbid, that something bad happens. But I'm definitely gonna start to get into stretching out more and taking care of it because
good stretch, good warm up, man. You should be good to go.
Yeah, for sure.
That's all you need.
There we go.
Where's the especially if you're gonna live heavy like crazy. You know?
Especially, bro, man. I be going into man.
What do you recommend as far as a like lifting schedule almost? Do you do a lot of reps with minimal weight or a lot of weight with minimal reps? Give me a little bit of the rundown of what you would do when you go into the gym.
Yeah, I always keep it like between 8-15 reps.
Okay.
Depending on how I feel that day, let me tell you, that's for sure. Depending on how I feel, there's some days that I just like want to go very heavy and do 6 to 8 reps. But then the different type of exercise, I switch that around. So I don't do like the same thing in all of them. But I always, myself to my clients, we always keep it 8, 10, 12, 15 reps. Now, there's some weeks that they call it deload. So you lower the weight. And you do a little bit more extra reps. So basically, it all depends. It depends how we start the program. What's the goal? You know. So because if you're gonna go for strength, then which is a different program from getting that body, that bitch body. It's different. Then for strength, you keep those low reps, high volume, like heavy weights. And I think you have a video of me.
Yeah. Actually, we're going to play that real quick. There's a couple of videos that we got of my man Rafa real quick.
So there we were working on actually strength.
Okay.
But that's not the main exercise. We have a lot of exercise more that I do. Mm. Like the other exercise, I do it for hypertrophy. So which we go 8 to 15. Reps.
Okay.
But with a good amount of weight that you can like struggle a little bit.
Without
losing the form. Remember that.
So is the number one most important thing the form more than the amount of reps, more than the weight? Is it the form? Because I heard like it's better to do one rep correct with the correct form, correct weight or whatever, and you'll get more done than if you do 15 with the bad form and bad weight.
Yeah, because the muscle ain't getting that work done correctly.
Mm.
So you're just probably getting the pump. Mm-hmm. What they call it, pump.
The pump. Okay. Yeah. You look big for 30 minutes.
A lot of guys just go on Friday night.
Take a picture and then we call it a day, boy.
So 25, 30 reps on the bicep curls.
When you
want
to go to 11, you know what I'm saying, before.
So is it regular to feel sore every day? Is that something you aim for? Like the next day, if you don't feel sore, you're like, I didn't work out hard enough? Or
Not really. It all depends, it depends the intensity that you go, and it all depends how much water you drink, your nutrition, the food, and everything.
Really?
But I've been sore for the last 5 months.
Oh my God.
I've had a sore life, bro.
thank you to my coach.
Yeah.
Oh, man. No, I mean, it's for real, man. It's been, but again, it's like we've been hitting it. The intensity is on our level. It's on our level.
Yeah.
So my body's feeling it.
Hey, go ahead.
No, but to answer your question, if you don't feel sore and you get a good workout that day, that doesn't mean that you didn't work out.
Sometimes I'll feel like that. Sometimes when I'm not sore the next day, I'm like, coño, I didn't work out hard enough. Shit, yeah. I got to go harder next time. And it's like, sometimes
that's good. That's, you can go harder.
There we go. Now, sometimes I don't know if it's also normal. Or maybe like I won't feel sore the next day, but 2 days later I feel it, and I'm just like, what the fuck? So I work out on legs. The next day I'm all right, but then the second day is where it's like you try to sit down, you get up, you're like, oh, hold on,
that delay soreness, bro.
So that's a thing. That's an actual thing that happens. Like that's normal.
Yeah.
Okay.
But that's not everybody. Everybody's different.
Yeah. Okay.
So before I used to be like that with legs.
Okay.
But then as the intensity changed, man, I'm feeling it the same day.
Jesus.
On the same day, I'm like, sheesh, gone.
You're done.
That's it.
Yeah, bro. You can't go clubbing that night. No, bro. We Netflix and chilling night.
You can't do nothing. You gotta get the hamstrings.
Yeah, for real. Have you ever tried the those massage guns so they help you out?
They help. They help a lot with the soreness. Yeah.
Okay.
If you're very sore and you can get one, like, get
definitely.
Because that's going to help. That's everybody that's watching. If you.
That's what's up. What I guess, how do I put this? Where do you see yourself going with the sport? Where do you see yourself long term as far as like where bodybuilding is concerned, where personal training is concerned? Do you have any concrete ideas of maybe like... like where your program would go in the next few years? Like what do you got planned?
If I keep into bodybuilding, which is my plan, I wanna give it a shot to turn pro. Mm. That will be a big accomplishment for me. Work wise, I'll just train as a trainer, coach. I just wanna be one of the best trainers.
That's what's
one of the best coaches out there.
Yeah, so. Sounding like Ash Ketchum right now.
Come on, somebody.
So I just want to learn. The more I learn, the more I can teach to my clients, teach to my trainees, and that's the goal, man. That's the goal.
That's
maybe one day be owner of have my own gym.
Hell yeah,
that's what's up.
Hell yeah.
So that's the idea. But I'm taking it day by day, learning, giving it to the people out there, you know.
Hell yeah.
It's not only to my clients, because if you follow me, you know what?
Yeah.
I try to motivate as much as I can.
No, I always see you at the gym, even for someone that's not your client. If you see them doing something wrong, you always like, let me help you out real quick.
Yeah,
and and I think that's fucking awesome.
Yeah. And let me tell you, a lot of people take that wrong.
Which, dude, that's so fucking stupid.
I've seen it. They get so offended. They're like, no, I'm fine.
Man,
like, it's like, all right, bitch.
Like,
hurt yourself.
Like, all right, bro. Get a herniated disc.
Exactly.
Like,
people take that wrong. I don't know why.
It's their pride. It's just their pride. Like, oh, I know what I'm doing.
Yo, like, clearly he's saying it because, like, he has the knowledge. He's not pretending to be better than anyone. Like, you're just trying to help out. So I hate when people get that. Those are misconceptions. Yeah, I think that's stupid.
I tried to stop doing that last year. Like, less than I used
to.
No way. I just can't see somebody doing like crazy stuff and stay quiet.
Dude, that's an injury waiting to happen.
Bro, I've seen some crazy shit. I've seen some people doing some wild shit.
I've seen those videos. Like, people are like working out, like, doing crazy shit. Like.
It's too much. Have you ever had to come to somebody's rescue? Like, you ever seen somebody benching and they're just like stuck there and they have no spotter?
Yeah, okay.
Actually,
not here. Like, right in the chest.
On the chest. What the fuck?
What happened is that people put clips. Normally, when they go heavy, they put clips.
So they don't fall out.
But he didn't? He actually did. From my opinion, you shouldn't do that.
No clips?
Because if you don't have the strength, if you by yourself, you bench in 225 and you fail, what are you going to do? You're going to put the bar on your chest and you're just going to go slide to one side, slide to the other one.
True.
The plate's going to fall out.
True.
That's it. But that kid was suffering, man.
If it was me, I mean, you should have walked up to him and be like, look, I can help you, but you have the clips. Why did you put the clips? He's like, you don't imagine.
Yeah.
That's funny. No, that's smart, though. I never thought about that.
That's my opinion, man. A lot of people, everybody's different outside.
That's what's up. We actually have a recurring little theme here. We got movies from Craig. We got thumbs up review movie reviews from Craig. So do we got a movie for our listeners today?
Well, actually, I have a question.
Okay.
Craig, have you seen Bad Boys, the new one? He hasn't. Dang it. I was going to ask if he gave it a thumbs up. I've heard mixed reviews, so I'm trying to figure out.
I have to go and watch it.
It has to be a thing.
We got anything?
What movie you think about, man?
What we got?
What you think about old or new?
Craig's mind is churning.
With Dr. Parnassus.
Dr. Parnassus.
Bro, he be throwing these movies.
Where are these movies from, man?
He's like,
oh, you can only find it on like a third website in Israel.
You need a VPN.
Yeah, he's like, for sure.
So thumbs up.
Yeah, for real.
You gave a thumbs up to Dr. Parnassus?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, Johnny Depp.
Johnny Depp.
So if I can throw out something out there,
Heath Ledger.
I saw Parasite and 1917. I don't know if you've seen any of them.
I saw 1917.
Dude, well, okay, what'd you think?
All right, so 1917, the fact that shit was almost one continuous shot.
That's fucking
very
remarkable.
Very impressive.
Very, very impressive.
Very, very impressive. So it's
the
about
technical feat. I don't know if you've seen it.
I haven't watched it now.
Yeah, dude. So I saw it with Danny, actually. Yeah. And fucking, it's a war movie, but a lot of it is made to look like it was shot in one take. So it was like if you kind of like just hit record and like start filming, and they did like an hour, like 2 hours of that, you know, like of one continuous, like never stopped.
No, there's no cut scene.
Yeah.
Just one time, I think.
When he gets knocked out. I don't know if they, like when they would like go through walls, I think those might have been cut scenes, but again, they were so smooth that you can't tell. I don't know. I have to see. But I highly recommend it.
1917.
It's in the movies now.
Right.
Are you a big movie head? Like, what do you do when you're not getting that pump, you know?
Sleeping.
Sleeping? Yeah, that recovery, boy.
Yeah. I'm not a lot into, I love movies, but I have three kids. So talk to me. I have a big girl, 11 years old, so talk to me about Frozen and stuff.
Oh, man.
Okay, cool.
Then Mickey Clubhouse.
He's like, hey, quiz me on that shit. I know that.
But I love action movies.
Okay.
I love action movies, comedy, horror movies.
Okay, I'm a big horror movie fan. Yeah.
Horror movies. Even though I get scared, like.
For real?
Those chill.
Yeah.
But I still love it.
That's what's up.
So you said you're a father. So as a Dominican, as yes, Dominican,
they are.
There you go. Yeah. What are your rules as far as your daughter dating? Like, she can't date till she's 40. Like,
I would not.
I want to know.
Listen, if I was taking out a girl to prom and I go to pick her up and he opens the door,
I would freak out.
Yo, I'd be like, hey,
no, never mind.
I lost my ticket, yo.
Because for me, it's like, you know, even with my niece, I'm like, you're not getting married till you're 52. And then you won't have sex until you're 60. Yeah. So how do you, like, what's your take on it, man? How do you?
I think it's going to take a while for her. It's going to take a while. Actually, I have a shirt that it says D-A-D-D.
Uh-huh.
It says Dad Against Dating Daughters.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, my God.
I got that t-shirt, like, probably 4 years ago.
Yeah.
And I showed it to my daughter. She saw it. So that's a huge bodybuilding grabbing a little kid from the neck. And then it says, D-A-D-D. And she still remember that.
That's hilarious. That
t-shirt. Oh, and I always tell her, like, do you remember the t-shirt?
Yeah, just so when you remember.
A friend.
Okay.
But she's still little, so she's 11.
Man. Yeah, okay, you still have time. But eventually, bro, I'm telling you, it's going to come to a time where she's going to start dating.
Yeah,
you got to, you know.
I mean, if I'm not this big, I'll get a shotgun.
Yeah. That was a shortcut.
Yeah.
Just clean out the shotgun when he comes over.
Yeah, for sure. So how you doing?
No, for sure.
What is your... Does your daughter think, so little backstory, when my uncle was, he was in a wheelchair, and when I was a kid, like, he had always been in a wheelchair. So because that's the only thing that you're exposed to, I thought, like, all uncles are in wheelchairs. Cause I, like, that's the only thing, that's not, cause that's, I only had one uncle and that's the only, and then when I met other kids and that wasn't the case, I was like I was tripping out. Yeah. So does your daughter, does she find it normal now, like how fit you are, how big you are, like that sort of thing? Like,
yeah, well, by now, yes.
Okay. Because you've pretty much been this size or near the size, like, for the majority of her life, right?
Yeah, correct.
And I'm sure that she gets, your work ethic, I guess she would be inspired by how consistent you work out and that sort of thing. Does she ever tell you anything about that or no?
About that, no. But the two boys, they're into it. But even though she likes to exercise, she's like jump rope. She's learned to jump rope and stuff like that. And you should be doing your routines daily, okay? But the boys are like into push ups and hanging everywhere. So
he comes home, they're like on the roof.
Doing flips.
Oh my God.
Just like
calisthenics.
But they have good genetics, man. They're small, they're little, and they still have their shape. Their
nice. Six
pack. Hey,
the shape is there. So I'm proud.
Hey, come on. That elementary school brag right there.
I saw a video. It was a joke. I think it was a tweet, actually. And it was like a video of somebody's baby doing like push-ups. And he's like, oh, my baby's doing push-ups. He's getting large. And then somebody commented, horrible form, fucking idiot. And I'm like, oh my God. So now that raises the question. When you're like, I don't know if your sons ever work out, but are you like strict with their form? Like, hey, that's not a good push-up.
They 5 and 7.
So. Oh, okay. All right. No,
I little. But I think I saw that. I saw that video.
The video of the little baby.
It's a little baby.
It was just funny to me that people weren't that wild.
That just... I think they pose that just as motivation. Like, remember there's somebody watching what you're doing.
You know?
There's always somebody watching what you're doing.
Always have something to say.
Even though if you don't have kids, you can be your niece. Like, you just, you know, there's always somebody watching.
That's funny, Zella.
Looking at some of your competition picks, and our viewers can see them now as well. What's the deal with the 10? Everybody is. How long before competition do you get the tan?
Do you go to the beach?
I mean,
there's people that start preparing their skin, taking like a tan on the beach and stuff like that.
So what's the point of that?
I thought they were all spray tans, though.
Yeah, they do. They spray tan you the night before.
Okay.
Like one coat, then you get another two coats the same day.
What the fuck?
Before is that. It? But when you go to sleep, does it like get off on the sheets and shit?
Oh, yeah, you need new sheets.
Oh, no.
Which
way.
I have a bad experience on my first show because I didn't know. I didn't know anything about it. So when I went to the hotel, they made me sign
look like a murder scene.
They made me sign a paper which say like, okay, if you stain the sheets, it's gonna be 15. The pillow cover is gonna be that, 15.
Those Airbnb fees, boy.
And you didn't know.
So I had to go to Walgreens. That was the only thing. They didn't have any sheets. So I have to buy this huge beach towel.
Put it on
the floor because I didn't know if it was gonna be through it was gonna go through the towel.
On the bed.
So man, that was a bad night.
So you slept on the floor?
I slept on the floor.
That's fucking dedication. He's like, I don't know about y'all, but my tan's going to be on point.
I'm not paying no extra fucking fees.
Fuck these fees. Yeah, that's fucking dope. And then it's for the definition.
You can see more details on stage with the lighting and everything is
makes sense.
Is set up for that.
Okay.
And then they do another two coats the day of?
The day of the show.
Okay.
Maybe three if somebody wants it or need it.
Okay.
What are some of, I'm sure, were you a little bit nervous the first time? What are some of the things that you do when you go on stage and what were you nervous about the first time that you competed?
I'm nervous right now a little bit because I'm not used to talking. So that day, man, it's nervous. Nothing about being on stage with the good lighting on your face and probably 100 people watching you. You have your routine for posing and showing what you got.
Yeah.
And try not to forget, try to open the back good and things like that. So all that together the first time, even though the last time I was kind of nervous too.
Mm. Okay.
So you just want to have everything perfect, you know?
Yeah.
As far as the how the vibe is behind the scenes, how are the other contestants? Is it an amicable environment where everybody's kind of like hoping the best for everybody? Or is it like, ah, fuck this guy?
Fake?
Damn. Yeah?
Damn.
Sometimes.
Give me a little, you don't have to name names, but give me a little backstory.
No, you're always going to find that. Yeah. That's going to be everywhere. But yeah, sometimes everybody's like, yo, you look great.
Mm.
Good luck. And then it turned like this.
Hopefully he laughs
and chill. For real?
Yeah, that everywhere is like that.
Yeah.
I have that everywhere.
It's bound to happen. And as also our viewers can see, and I've seen myself, you recently started like dabbling into the, boxing game, MMA. I know you would do that before as well. Talk to me about that.
I always liked boxing, but I got into it more to when I became a personal trainer so I can teach my clients.
Okay.
And as my main goal was to train girls at the beginning, it was like, okay, which girl don't like to hit something?
Yeah.
All of them like to hit something.
Okay.
For real.
So I got my certification into boxing and stuff like that. And then I'm like, you know what? I'm going to jump into it.
Yeah.
And then I did for a little bit. And I kept this year like hitting the back just for extra cardio so I can eat a little bit more.
Hey.
And recently I started doing meat work. And learning more with Chris.
Shout out to Chris.
Coach Chris. But I love it. I mean, if I get into it, I'll see myself also probably doing something.
Hell yeah. And dude, I see him out there and it's exciting. So I was like, damn, if I were to see him fight, like, dude.
Yeah, I was going to ask, like, since you've learned it, like, not before, but from the moment you started learning boxing, have you ever gotten to a fight and had to use what you learned?
No, I'm very peaceful.
Okay, yeah. Unless somebody dates his daughter. So as long as he's dating his daughter, he won't have to use it on you.
Yeah, that's the only thing I guess.
Yeah. Right now, I know a lot of people that when they train, they try not to fight because they know what they can do.
Yeah.
And it's like, yo, I'd rather just avoid that.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I'd rather just walk away.
That's and I see that with everybody who trains martial arts and or boxing or just in general, they don't want to fight.
Exactly. And even, they know.
And even me, I know how I get when I'm angry and I fight. I'm like, bro, I'd rather not fight unless, you know, there's a threat or you feel me, one of my family members. That's when it happened. But for arguments, bro, get out of my face. It ain't worth it. It really isn't.
That's the worst.
It ain't worth it, bro. Exactly. I just wanted to see if maybe, you know, he's run into somebody that tried some shit.
I bump with people sometimes and I'm like,
Yeah. No, but they probably look at this nigga and they're like,
yeah, like, yeah. Hey, no, yeah, yeah, sorry. You want a new shirt?
Yo, did the hotel did they feed you for the tan? I got you. I'll pay for you.
That's funny, yeah, though.
Yeah. Do you have any aspirations to fight? Is this something that you're just learning to be able to implement to your other students? Or is it something that you're genuinely interested in maybe having an amateur debut? What are you thinking?
I'm interested into have something.
Hell yeah. That's what's up. That's what's up.
I mean, you guys are there and everything that you guys motivate me to get into it. Hopefully gonna get the time to get into jiu-jitsu.
Hell yeah.
It's like my schedule is mixed, so it's...
Well, I was gonna ask, you know, being a father of, you know, of three, how are you able to manage something that's so demanding as bodybuilding and something that's so consistent as bodybuilding with that sort of thing? How are you able, you know, it seems like you must be great at time management.
I mean, It's tough. But I try just to do everything while they are in school or they're sleeping, things like that.
Ladies and gentlemen, if let's say you are a professional bodybuilder, you know, and you get swole on a regular basis, and you need a short film of a collage of all your muscles being portrayed to the masses. Who do you call? You call fucking Tom. Is who you fucking call. You call at Tom J Moore, and by call I mean DM, you know. Hit him up at Tom J Moore. You see it on the screen. You see his beautiful face. He's a very talented individual. He's so professional that you're gonna feel like you're in Canada, you know, and it's beautiful. Call Tom. Call him now.
That was amazing.
It was beautiful. Yeah. But back to our show. Rafa, what's maybe something that you want to tell our listeners? Something maybe a little bit, you know, on the motivational side. Get them going. Some of them don't get up at 4 a.m. and some of them have been trying. How do you get up at 4 a.m, man? You know, sometimes, bro, I'm not kidding.
I go to sleep bro, at like 5 or 6.
I'm not kidding, like 17 fucking alarms. I sleep through like all of them, bro.
Right,
like,
dude, I feel it.
What do you, give me something, bro. Give me something.
That's how my day starts. 4 a.m. I wake up, 5 a.m. I have my first client, 6, 2nd, 7, 3rd, 8, sheesh. All the way almost to noon sometimes, some days. But
you don't hit that wall.
Some days, man, it's like
what the cafecitos for.
Yeah, bro.
That's what I told you earlier. It's like I drink coffee from early morning to the night because I finish. Well, sometimes now that I'm boxing,
he gets up late, yo.
Yeah. At 9 p.m., I'm still boxing, and then. Yeah.
Well, the caffeine is also supposed to help with the burning fat too. I heard. Is that a myth?
Yeah, it helps to get your heart rate up, and it helps to.
Okay.
But they're myth.
It's myth. Things, yeah, and then the bad myths. Okay.
So people say that it can affect your joints. Other people say, or studies, they say that it can help you with the soreness.
Really?
That's crazy. So it's very.
Yeah. I don't know.
Okay.
But going back to your question, it's man, it's goals. I want to see you. I woke up early just to, because I know that I want to see my clients looking good.
Hey, come on.
And I know I'm going to have a great workout that day. So I try to get that into my mind as soon as I wake up. Today's going to be a great day. So
let's get it. That's what I'm saying. Do you do any mantras? I know the self, what are those called? That people like repeat things to themselves. What are those called?
Affirmation.
Affirmation. Yeah. And I know that's been big. I mean, I personally haven't done it. Is it something that you do, or when you get up, do you already kind of have that drive mentality?
I have the let's get a mentality. That's my motto right there. You know, I even have it on my hat and everything.
Hey, let's get it.
So in my shirts and everything. So it's like, okay, it's Monday. let's get it.
Yeah. Hey.
Okay, this is going to be heavy. Sometimes you see me in the videos, I'm like thinking about it. Okay, this is going to be 140 pounds, but you know what? Let's get it.
Yeah. So, those moments right before you're about to start, then you say, you're like,
yeah.
Hi.
Exactly. So yeah, man, that's my motto, man. Let's get it.
What, if it's not too personal, give me a rough estimate of how much you spend on food given a given week.
Well, thankfully, because it will be a lot. I have a sponsor.
Oh. Hey, let's get them plugs.
That's a Diromo's Fit Cuisine.
Come on. Okay. You see it on the screen, ladies and gentlemen.
So they provide me some food.
Okay.
Okay.
Which is 2-3 foods a day.
Are they like a meal prep service?
Yeah, they do meal prep services.
Okay, cool. What sort of food are we talking about?
Well, for me, it's regular food.
Regular,
which is white rice, chicken, lean ground beef, and stuff like that. But it's they do healthy stuff.
Okay, that's very cool.
Their main thing.
And I'm assuming that that takes off a burden off of your shoulders.
Yes, a lot. Because in the meat, and it's where the protein is, where the money goes.
Yeah.
You know, because you definitely can get a bag of rice for $5. But,
and
it can last the whole week. But,
I had another question, because there's a lot of, like you said, there's a lot of different body types. So there's also a lot of different people who work out. Mm. And not to say, I'm not asking if you do, but for those people who maybe smoke and drink, does that affect the workout? Like if you're working out high or maybe you just get high after, is that
have you had a client show up to a private high?
No, never.
No,
never.
Now that he knows.
Now that I know.
But you can tell.
You can tell.
Yeah.
And I bet. None of you.
And don't.
But that's a new thing. Now the CBD is like.
Yeah.
They're incorporating it. Yeah.
So,
but you don't know of anything that may affect, like maybe smoking. Does it have any negative effects?
No, the smoking. But the drinking, the drinking is going to be affecting you though. Not even with the training, with everything.
Okay, yeah, it's true.
But now the smoking, it's kind of the la moda.
It kind of is
popular, yeah.
And I ask because it's also getting legalized. Necessarily on the smoking side, but you know, I drink from time to time.
I dabble
in the alcoholic consumption, and I've gone to the gym, maybe not drunk, but a little like, you know, lit or whatever.
Hey.
And it's funny because I don't feel the workout. So I'm like, this is great because I'm so numb, I don't feel it. So I'm actually working out better. So I don't know if that has anything. You've never worked out a little drunk, no?
No, never.
I'm an idiot. I know. I was like, let's go to the gym, y'all. Let's do it. And I'm there. A few Heinekens in. Yeah. It's just hilarious.
You say it yourself.
Yeah, there we go.
Sweat that tequila out, boy.
Tequila out, man. That's all it is.
You can wait until next day at least, man.
Yeah.
You can't. I mean, if you go drunk, you can do something stupid and just.
Yeah, like, you're right.
Injure yourself. Okay.
You're right.
What do you, for jiu-jitsu, do you plan on going into jiu-jitsu or boxing separate? Do you think of doing MMA like as a whole combined? What's your plan on that?
Let's take it step by step. So I started boxing. I would like to do MMA. Okay. I would like to try that out at least once.
For sure. Yeah.
At least once.
I think
so. That's why I want to get into jiu-jitsu with you guys.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't.
Yeah, that's some other stuff right
there. I'd rather to go with people that I know than
of course, that you're comfortable with. Yeah. How long do you think that a client should expect to wait before they see significant results?
I always tell them give me 3 months. But
because you'll transform their body?
If they follow my tips and my instructions, they can. The yeah.
Okay.
Because what I do is we do check-ins every 2 weeks. I do check-ins with all my clients every 2 weeks.
Like what, send me pictures, see what's up?
Sorry?
Like send me pictures, picture see, like process weight. Pictures.
Yeah, okay. Process pictures and weight. So from there, we switch the nutrition and we go from there.
So your program is a full-on, so it's not only the working out, it's also the food part of
it. Correct. Yeah, correct.
Okay, very cool.
I provide both.
Okay, so you're kind of taking care of everything.
Yeah.
That's what's up.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Because
yeah.
a lot of people, is, you know, a lot like, of people just, don't know what they need to eat.
Exactly. They don't know the nutrition aspect. You can work out all you want, but if you're eating pizza, you ain't going to do shit. Yeah. You know?
Unless you're my body type.
It's definitely body type.
An anamorph.
Little Caesars and all that. We're good, man. We're good.
Little Caesars.
And it's like that, man. People think that with the training only, they're going to get results. And that's when they're... lack of motivation
gets into place.
They're just like, okay, I'm not changing, but they don't know they're just like eating pizza, it's gonna affect that much.
I also think that it's I think like depression has a big play into it, as far as like you not like maybe you not being able to like conquer that monster, like the food or the desire to actually want to better yourself. A lot of the times it comes, it's rooted from maybe they're going through a depression or something. But I do think that if they do take the initiative, that there's several studies that have been done that say that working out helps tremendously with depression.
With depression, yes.
Yeah. Have you seen maybe what's been a very like rewarding transformation that you've seen in a client that it wasn't only like physical, but that you could tell like
mentally?
Yeah. Like, tell me something about that.
Well, I haven't trained anybody with some like type of depression. Okay. Like that, but let me tell you that within the time, you can notice that people start like changing their attitude, their mood is...
Their confidence?
Their mood is changed. Mm-hmm. Their confidence...
I feel like confidence goes up like crazy.
The girls, when they start the long sleeve, cover, and stuff like that, and then... 4 weeks, 5 weeks after, you see them like
crop top,
and stuff like that, and that's confidence, man.
That's confidence.
That's good. I love to see that with my clients, especially because I know that I'm doing something good.
Yeah.
And that's a morale booster. Everybody sees that. They're like, damn, that's what's up. You know, everybody wants to keep working. That's what's up. That's dope.
Definitely. Do you feel that most of your clients is social media, word of mouth? Like, what do you...
Word of mouth.
Yeah.
And social media as well. Some of them. But mostly, man, word of mouth is what it is.
Yeah, it is. Because I think one of the most amazing ways to, like, just push yourself is word of mouth.
Word of mouth.
Yeah, bro, goes so far.
Somebody, let's see, some of the girls saw a picture of this girl that did the transformation with me. Oh, who's your coach? I want to talk to him like that. So they refer to me and I get it.
Are you a fan of how big social media is? Are you big on it? Like, are you kind of, what do you stand on this?
Social media is huge, man.
Yeah. It's...
I remember that was last year when Instagram went down.
Oh yeah.
And everybody was going, even me, I was going crazy because I couldn't do shit that day.
You're like, wait, that's my bread and butter right there.
You know the people that lost money that day, like per minute?
It's crazy.
So that's how big the social media is right now. We're depending on that. I bet my boy right here is on Instagram right now, no?
No.
taking care
of the studio. It's been hectic today, man.
There's an event going on.
We have an event going on and all that.
That's a good problem to have.
It's definitely a good problem to have. Definitely a good problem to have. Are there any competitions in the horizon for you? What are maybe some short-term maybe events or anything that maybe you know your fans or your clients can look forward to?
Well, not for myself right now, but I'm coaching three of my clients. They're gonna compete in.
Oh shit!
Yeah, they're gonna compete in April, and then actually there's one that I'm doing like online.
Oh wow!
Which is competing in 7 weeks.
Very cool.
Then the other three that I see them every day. They are like 14 and 15 weeks out.
Okay. So, is it hard for you to make that connection when you're coaching someone online, or do you still kind of break through somehow?
Online is harder than in person, man.
Yeah.
You have to commit yourself like to, not 100%, you have to commit 120%.
Is it text or videos? What do you do?
Text.
Yeah?
Everything is text or emails. Yeah.
That's intense, dude.
Yeah. But, I mean, if the person is into it 100%, 120, then it's going to be done.
You can tell they're doing it.
Yeah, you can tell. As soon as they send that picture, man, that private picture, you're like, okay, he's putting the work.
Yeah.
Or get the comité.
You
shouldn't be like this right now.
Because you learn within the time you learn and you start seeing it.
Yeah.
Some days I ask some of the clients, like, you had a good weekend, right? Because you can see in the skin texture change, like when you're reaching a little bit of water and things like that.
Yeah.
How much do you, before competition or like the day before, 2 days before, is it true that you have to drink very little to no water?
There's different, depending on the coach, but normally, yeah, what you do is like you get that intake a couple of, like a week before, you put it super high, and then you start dropping until that day you just like take some sips. So it's true, but there's some other coaches that just tell you like, okay, just drink your water.
Have you ever overdid it to the point that you felt like lightheaded or maybe you puked?
No.
I mean, I had a first que me desinflé and kind of went back up, and now I'm trying to kind of desinflar de nuevo. But when I was first doing it, there was some times where I would do a cardio class, I would go to the bathroom, I puke because I was overdoing it.
But the water intake and stuff like that, or the water?
No, because estaba mareado. Like I was working out too hard. Like I was running too much. It was cardio.
That was one of the Danny's classes, right?
100%. Not even doubting it. Shout out to Danny. Danny fucking goes in those cardio classes.
Yeah.
That's never happened to me from weights, but yeah, like cardio, that sort of thing.
But man, it can happen in weights, especially when you're working out legs. I actually, last week, my first time in all the time that I've been working out, that was the first time I almost, well, I don't want to say almost, I did. I threw up like twice.
Jesus.
Damn. Yeah. But from, was the intensity. Yeah,
it was too much weight.
So too much weight, too much repetition. So, because we switch everything around now.
Yeah.
And we need these babies to grow. So now it's different, man. So now we're taking it.
Yeah.
Tuesday, I told him like, yo, this was a next level now.
Yeah.
Damn. But they just coaches, we just laugh like,
yeah.
Like you puke.
Yeah. Good job.
Danny is the good same job. Thing. Yeah. Do you take BCAAs to help you with soreness?
It helps with the recovery.
Yeah.
Yeah. It helps with to recover the muscle a little bit faster. Everybody take it a different way. I'd rather to take it. I feel it works better for me when I start taking it like, almost at the end of the workout. Instead of waiting for me to finish the workout. So that's my opinion. For me, works better.
What do you think about pre-workouts? Do they get you jittery? Like, what do you think
about
them?
That's one component that they put in there. Is, I believe is the arginine.
Oh, yeah. Arginine.
Which give you that, it doesn't do anything. It's like give you that feeling.
Feel
like, you feel like you're just going to take everything. Kill it. But pre-workout, I do it depending on the body part that I'm going to work that day. So if I need that extra boost.
Do you do one main, like maybe you do chest and you'll do a smaller body part? What do you normally do?
I normally do chest by itself, which is a big muscle. So I try, it all depends how you want to improve that body part.
Yeah.
So if you want to improve your chest, it's better to take it by itself and focus all the energy that and all the nutrients into that muscle. Even though you work in chest, you're going to be touching the triceps.
Yeah.
So and so on. But normally, yeah, big muscles by themselves and then small muscles like together.
Together?
Yeah. Except for arms. I don't do that much arms.
I'm serious.
For what? Real?
Wait, I don't do that much arms.
What do you mean? So happened naturally?
Yeah, it's just God.
That's just big.
God just said, here, you're welcome.
Pulled out a Popeye.
I used to a lot, but I was talking about this yesterday. The thing is that when I hit the arms, they overcompensate my shoulders. So they look bigger than my shoulders. So I hit it like very light, not light. But two exercise maybe.
Damn,
that's a good problem to have right there.
Bro, that's a good problem.
Damn, I hate when my biceps bigger than my shoulder.
Yeah, man, it's like, my arm is overcompensating. Like,
no shame when that happens, Craig.
For real, yo.
that's dope though. That's fucking awesome. Rafa, it's been an absolute banger and absolute pleasure having you on today.
Yeah, my pleasure.
I know there's a couple sponsors we want to give a shout out to.
Well, I have sponsors, three sponsors. My Betancourt Nutrition.
Okay.
They provide me with what keeps me going through my workouts. Man, those supplements are, on the top.
Oh, yeah.
Top of the line, yeah. Did almost, which we talk about it, the food and Miami Iron Gym.
Okay.
And that's my home. That's second home. And that's it, man.
You know? That's what's up. That's what's up.
Keep moving forward.
Keep moving forward. How often are you getting, because I know you kind of, there was an injury that you had. Maybe you were getting some massages done. How often do you get that done? Talk to me about that a little bit.
Well, that one actually was, I think I pulled something on my ribs, on intercostal muscles. So I've been feeling it, and I've been getting that treated as soon as I can, because I can spend 1 week or two weeks without working out.
That's that vice. Huh? Yeah. That's that plug.
Yeah,
huh?
Come on, somebody.
So, but you should do maintenance on yourself, like at least once or twice a month, man.
Okay.
Like get that adjustment. Get that deep tissue massage.
Where do you go to get that done?
Well, I have two places. I have Kevin Fix Me.
Okay. Yep.
I don't know.
I've heard of him. Yeah, yeah.
And then I have a Morph, which is a rehab place that is in Kendall.
Mm.
Okay. So lately, I've been going to Morph to get that done.
Very cool. Very cool.
So they help. It helps, man.
That's what's up. Yeah. That's what's up. Yeah. Well, I hope that you have a very speedy recovery. I know that you're going to be back in the gym in no time. Ill, is there anything you want to leave our listeners with?
Yeah. Rest in peace, Kobe Bryant.
I knew it.
It's been on my mind.
I knew.
So, yeah, man. Rest in peace, Kobe Bryant, bro. Yeah. And my condolences to his family and everybody and all his fans, myself included. So, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Craig, you got anything for the people?
But
No words from Craig.
But I know. Thank you guys for real. Yeah, but for me, it's a pleasure.
No, for
nice
sure.
To meet you.
And thank you.
To the people out there, just like keep working on your goals, man. Never give up.
Hell yeah.
Let's get it. Let's get it.
Just how it says. Let's get it.
Come
you
on,
know.
Somebody.
You know. You talked about those 2020 resolutions for a motherfucking month in 2019. Make them happen. You know.
Exactly.
Don't make it. You know. Don't let it just be a little Instagram post. Yeah. Make it happen.
There's no excuses.
There's no excuses. You know. No excuses. You know.
And we have a coach here, a trainer. So exactly. If y'all need to hit him up.
Exactly. You need. Listen.
He'll get y'all
if you
right.
need a body transformation.
Come on.
If you need to look like, listen, if you, let's say your ex is coming back into town,
and
she hasn't seen you in a hot minute, and you looking a little flubby,
you know,
might want to make her a little jealous.
Yeah.
What you gonna do?
Come on, somebody.
You hit on my man Rafa, and he gets you right. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Come on, hit him up on the DM. You know, you see all his information on screen right now. He's a professional. He really is. I've seen him work with a lot of clients. Many times his reviews and the vouchers for his work is honestly great. And I've never heard a single complaint ever.
Thanks. That's a good thing to know.
Of course. but yeah, bro, hit him up if you need that body transformation, or if you need to talk about any sort of nutrition or body sort of questions, he's got you. He's very knowledgeable on the matter. And you know, he's gonna take his client, he's gonna take care of his clients, and he's also very custom as far as like the work that he applies towards his client. It's not gonna be like, oh, you know, one diet that he writes and it's like I'm gonna give that shit out to everybody. That's not what's happening. You get a very personalized service, you know, something that's only made for you, and that's gonna work for you and your body. You know, so check him out. Rafa, again, thank you so much for coming through. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you, brother.
Thanks to you, brother.
Y'all be easy. Tune in every Thursday at midnight in Miami. See ya.
Miles away, yeah. I'm with the gang, plus I got more people on-